Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a basic description about the hydraulic trainer. So this is a basic hydraulic trainer. In this video we will be seeing about the basic description details of different hydraulic components. These are some basic hydraulic components that we incorporate in this complete trainer board so that you can easily be familiar with all the type of basic working of hydraulic, how the hydraulic systems are incorporated in the industrial purpose, and you can also get the study to how the hydraulic system works and how we can convert the forces through hydraulic and how we can do some heavy jobs using the hydraulic systems. So what is hydraulic system? The hydraulic system basically nothing but a power transmission system using oil to carry the power. In the basic hydraulic system, we just incorporate with the oil, which is known as hydraulic oil. The hydraulic oil transferred through a motor or a gear pump in a reserve from a reservoir, which is already stored in a reservoir or a tank, and then it is transferred through a hydraulic motor power with the power force, and using the hose pipes and different combinations, the force from the mechanical will be provided and incorporated with the oil system, and oil will be used to stimulate and working as a driving force to any mechanical component. In that case, in many cases we use cylinders like this. So these are the cylinders or piston rod cylinders. When the oil form in some case, this will push the cylinders up, and that's how hydraulic works. So in this video, I will explain you all the basic technology of the working of all the components provided in this system. Then you can perform all the experiment as described in this video of working. So let us move on to the complete component description. Then we see in the manual how the connections can be built up and how you can perform the experiment on that. So this is the closer look of this hydraulic system trainer. We will be see the complete order code. So the order code is 52286. You can use this order code to find out all the specification related to this complete trainer board, complete trainer system, and what you can learn from this for your knowledge expansion. And this is a complete design of this hydraulic system to working on with and to get the knowledge about hydraulics. So now I will explain you all the parts one by one. So we'll start with the single acting cylinder. So this is a single acting cylinder which have bore about 40 mm and it has a stroke of 100 mm. So the complete cylinder dimensions has a bore of 40 mm and completely it can expand up to 100 mm from this dead size. And this is a inlet for this. Here you can see this is a point over here. That point can be used for connecting the quick release coupling hose pipe. So you will also see the connection with this complete working video. Now we move on to our next component, which is a double acting cylinder. So this double acting cylinder has a bore of 40 mm. And similar 100 mm of stroke. This can similarly expand up to 100 mm from the upper, and these are some flow control valves for controlling the flow of both the sides are provided. So if you move them in clockwise, anti-clockwise, you can adjust the flow, though you can adjust the speed of movement of this cylinder from up and down. Flow is directly dependent on the speed for up moving movement of the piston. So this is a glycerin filled pressure gauge over here. So from this pressure gauge you can measure the pressure of the input from the motor or pump, hydraulic pump, and here you can measure the pressure from 0 to 100 kilogram per centimeter square, or you can measure the pressure from 0 to 1500 pounds per inch square. So these are the two readings of this pressure gauge. The pressure gauge has a 100 mm dial, and you can easily see with this needle type of pressure gauge on the pressure size and pressure value. Then This is the pressure relief valve. So it will start relieving the pressure to the other. And this is the pressure relief valve connected over here in the line. So when we release this, it start flowing the liquid or the hydraulic oil to the other components of the hydraulic system. And there is a warning or a message shown that the close the valve before starting the motor. So whenever you start the motor, you make sure the valve is in closed position, in proper anti-clockwise position. And if you want to open the valve after starting the motor, gradually increase the pressure. The pressure can be measured on the pressure gauge explained earlier. And after that, adjust the pressure requirement as per your working. And then after working with this complete setup, just close the valve, completely turn this to the anti-clockwise position. Then this is the pressure manifold over here. The manifold are required to incorporate with the pressure line. So pressure line is connected on the below side of this manifold, and there are two outlets for providing the pressure to any of the two output sockets. So you can connect it to any of the sources for providing pressure to operate the valves. Then this is the tank manifold. The tank manifold has the same process, just to return the line of pressure after working to force. And there is a non-return valve also connect for the tank line. So the water or the oil flow will be only happen from the downwards from this direction. The direction is mentioned on the NRV, the non-return valve, and the oil flow cannot be go from the upwards from this NRV. So this will only always connect the valve or the hose pipe from where the return line oil is coming, so that oil will be go through only downwards, never go upwards. Otherwise it will increase the pressure of line if you provide the flow from upwards and require the flow from upwards from this tank manifold. So tank manifold will provide the release pressure and release oil after working from the other components to the tank as a return line. Then we have the bleed off valve. In this valve, the flow control valve is also provided. You can control the flow using this, and this will provide the two tank lines to be incorporated with the one outlet of the tank. So here the two return line of the different valves can be connected to on the both tanks line, and then the valve can be provided the flow from both the lines for returning pressure inside the tank manifold. Then we have a block manifold. This is the block manifold and a 4x2 hand lever operated valve. In this is the A, B output lines, and this is the pump port over here, and this is the tank or return line of the pressure. So pressure line will be connected and this P port, the pressure port, and output will be continuously going through from the T port over here. And when you actuate the valve with this lever like this, this can be operated in one direction only. The pressure line and the tank line will be separately connected with this. So I will explain you the diagram also, which is printed on this wall, and that's how you can understand the working of this wall. So let us understand with the circuit of this 4x3 way hand lever operated wall. So this is the diagram of the circuit printed over here, you can see. So this has four ports, A, B, P and T. A, B are the operating ports for both the lines, and P is the pressure port and T is the tank outlet port. So in the normal condition, P will be connected with the A port over here. So P will be connected with the A port. So pressure from the P port will be continuously flowing to the A port, and B or T we can say is connected. So pressure from B will be going to the tank. So B will be connected with the T port in the normal condition. But when we actuate this lever like this, so this will interchange both the connections, and in that case the P line will be directly connected with the B line as the cross suggests, and the T line which is going the A pressure will be connected with the tank line, so that both the section will be interchanged. So when we operate this, in the normal condition, flow will be from P to A right now and from B to C, B to T. So pressure going to the A of the any port of the cylinder, and return line from the cylinder will be connected over B, and from B it is going to the tank line. But to operate, when we operate this lever right now, so in this condition P will be connected with B, and the pressure from the A line, which is now outgoing condition, will start flowing through the tank line and going starts outwards from the T manifold over here. So that's how the 4x2 way hand lever works. They has the four ports and works in two condition only, so that's why it is called 4x2 way hand lever valve. Then we have 4x3 way hand lever operated valve. This is also a hand lever operated valve. Manually actuation is required. So this is also has a manifold over here. This manifold requires to help the and keep to sustain the pressure of the high pressure line. And these are the four ports over here: A, B, P and T port. All four ports are required, so that's why it is called four. And this works in the three position. This is a normal condition, not actuation condition, and this is the first condition for actuation, and the lever operates in uppers also. So this is the third condition. So there are three conditions of operation, that's why it is called 4x3 hand lever valve operator. So I will also explain you the circuit of the valve, how we can see and how the valve will be worked through the example given in the user manual. So this is the basic working and example of the 4x3 hand lever operated valve is given. In this you can see there are three directions. In the normal condition, the middle position of the valve will be going on. The A, B, P and T ports are mentioned over here. So when there is no operation, the P line will be connected directly to the tank line, so there will be no operation. Direct pressure will be going to the tank line, and there will be no pressure on A, or neither on the A nor on the B port. But when we operate it into upwards direction, then in that case P port will be directly connected to A port and B port will be connected to T port. So the pressure line will be connected to A port when we actuate this upwards, and same time B port will be connected to T port. So pressure line will be going to A and the relief or return line will be connected to B, which going through the tank line. So this is the first position, and on the lower position the reverse action will be happen. The P port at this time will be connected with the B line, so there will be pressure from the B section, and the return line from the A will be connected to the T port. So the return line will be going and return oil flow from the outwards to the tank line. So that's how this 4x3 hand lever valve works. Now moving on to the lower section of this complete trainer board, there we have a electric motor. This is a single phase 1 HP 230 volt operated electric motor with a starter. The starter switch is connected over here. Starter is installed inside, so you just need to turn on and off this complete system, and the MCB is also provided for turning on and off the power to the system. Then this is the hydraulic power pack tank. So oil capacity has a 30 liter, and this is MS powder coated with oil level indicator. Breather and oil filter and suction are also connected over here. So this is a oil level indicator also. Oil level can be measured and seen on this lever indicator. Also there are some hose pipes with the quick release couplings are also provided. So this will be useful for doing and building up the connection for different type of operation and experiments given in the user manual. And the complete components and trainer systems are fixed and installed on a complete metal frame. This is a MS metal frame which is powder coated with a special design for long lasting working, and it has a very good life for working with this type of components. And there is a tire also. These are wheels are also with the lock mechanism are also provided, so it is easy to move this complete system to the corridors, to your office or where you want to work on this, on the demo, in the institutes or any other educational premises. So this is the complete description of this hydraulic system trainer. All the components working that I have explained, you can do all the experiments as given and described in the user manual. So now, as this is our demo piece, so we cannot fill the oil over here. So as the premises and at the demo session, this will be got dirty while working with the hydraulic oil. Always carry the rotten cloths and garbage cloths while working with the hydraulic trainer, as I am using all this right now. But we cannot fill the oil and we cannot operate this, but still I will explain you to facilitate the oil connections according to the user manual and according to the experiments, so that as I explained you in this video, you can do your connections and perform the experiments on your place. Now for the experiment number 5, till experiment number 4, all the theoretical details are as explained in this video. You can study them to get the proper knowledge and detailed explanation for 1 to 4 experiment. Now we move on to the experiment 5, which is a first practical experiment, and in which we will study the actuator speed control circuit. One of the greater advantage of fluid power is the ability to control speed of a cylinder, motor or a rotary actuator. The speed is primarily a function of oil flow and size of the actuator. So this is dependent only on the oil flow and the size. As we constant and make the constant of the size, actuator size is constant, so it directly dependent on the speed of the flow. So we'll control the flow with the flow control valve connected on the actuators or the cylinders, so that we can also control the speed control. So these are the connection circuitry. This is the double acting cylinder over here. This is the flow control valve, which is connected on the retracted end, and this is a 4x2 lever operated valve. So we'll use this, and this is the pump section and pump symbol, and pressure relief valve is also required. So, and then this is a tank reservoir. So outlet is connected. Procedure is given over here. For this, you have to connect the P from P manifold, connect hose pipe to port P of the 4x2 lever operated valve. Then we connect port A to 4x2 lever operated valve to an extracting port of the double acting cylinder, where both the port of cylinder having flow control valve. Retracting port of the cylinder connected to T manifold, and T port of the 4x2 lever operated valve connected to T of the manifold. Then we on the trainer, and you can slowly vary the flow of the control valve mounted on the extracting port of the double acting cylinder. Now we will do the oil connections as described in this video, and you can do oil connection as I described and perform your experiment. So we will start doing up the connections as given in the user manual. For this, we require the quick release couplings over here. So we'll use it one by one. So first we will do the connections for P manifold to the pressure port. For this, we just need to pull this quick release coupling like this. Over here you can see there are some bearing and holes. So when we pull this, this will give you opening to connect inside, and it will automatically be fixed. Just need to apply some force to adjust this properly. So we do same for this. We just need to connect this like quickly and press this properly, and this will get quick fixed in the pressure port. Similarly, the P manifold's pressure port will be connected to the P port of the 4x2 hand lever operated valve. Similarly, we'll connect this, push this slightly, and this will got connected like this. Now use another quick release coupling hose pipe, and this will be connected to the A port to the extracting end of the cylinder. So we just need to pull this and put it over there. So this is fixed on the A port of the 4x2 cylinder.
24 by 2 directional control valve, and this end will be connected to the extracting end of this double acting cylinder. So we require some rotten cloth where some leakages of oil will be in continuous form. While working with the residual oil inside the hose pipes will distract you while working, but you just adjust like this. So when the flow from the pressure line will come in this direction to the extracting end, this will start filling up the oil beneath the piston over here. So the piston rod will start moving upwards through this double acting cylinder. We can also control the flow of filling it inside by using this flow control valve. So that's how we can also achieve the speed control of this double acting cylinder. Now from the extracting end, we need to connect this to the tank line so that the flow or the oil fill inside the tank will be start filling and going to the return line through the tank. For this, take another hose with the quick release coupling and connect this on the retracting end over here. Some oil drops will continuously dropping right now, and this will be connected on the B port of this 4x2 direction control board. So this is the B port connection. Now we just need to connect the tank port to the tank manifold. For this required a shorter length coaxial coupling. Like this, tank port is connected, and always connect the return line to the tank manifold with the NRV so that there will be no outflow from the situation. So this is the basic connection of experiment number 5 over here. You can do your connection like as described in this, and when you fill the tank and start the motor and actuate the 5x2 lever, you can see the double acting cylinder going upwards from this. Also you can see the flow line. When you release this, this will automatically go retracted. But if you want to adjust the speed, just control the flow or flow control valve, and that's how you can achieve the speed control of this double acting cylinder. Now moving to the next experiment or the next circuit. In this is the meter out circuit. For this, the regulating flow from the cylinder is another way to control the speed. The circuit maintains a constant back pressure during the rod extension and prevents lunging if the load drops quickly or reverses. So procedure is same, but we just need to vice versa the cylinder connection. In this, from P manifold, connect the hose pipe to P port of the 4x2 operated valve, and then we have to connect port A of the 4x2 lever operated valve to the retracting end. In the earlier practical, we have connected to this extracting end. So in this, we will connect this port A to retracting end of the port of double acting cylinder and extracting end of port cylinder to be connected to tank manifold. So we'll do the connection as per the last connection. These are the last experiment connection that we have performed. We just need to interchange the connections of the double acting cylinder. That's why it is easy to work with the hydraulics, because diagnostics and working pressure is very easy to control. Over here you can see this is the A port hose of the 4x2 lever operated valve. So this is connecting right now to the extracting end, and the B port is connected to the retracting end. If we change both the connections, then we can achieve the meter out circuit for speed controlling. Over here now, right now, if we control the flow from the inlet, this will control the in pressure of the movement. But when we control the flow of the retracting end, it will control the in pressure to the outlet. For this, you just need to interchange these connections. Like this, you can remove the quick release couplings, and A port will be connected to the retracting end. Like this. So these are the just change to control the metering out circuit.
Now we will perform the C operation, in which we will perform the operation of bleed off circuit. This is the circuit diagram, easy to resemble and work is provided. So we will do circuits over here. And this is the schematic diagram, so understanding it in the hydraulic connection and procedure is given as follows. So we'll do the connections as given in the procedure. For this, we will first connect the P manifold with the hose pipe for port A of 4x2 and lever operated valve. So you can use 4x2 way or 4x3 way for this experiment. I am using the 4x3 way connections over here. So we'll use a quick release coupling for connecting it to the P manifold. Like this, P will be connected with the P port of the 4x3 quick release coupling, sorry, the 4x3 way hand lever operated valve. Then we will connect the A port of this 4x3 hand lever operated valve with the A port of the double acting cylinder. This is the extracting end port of the double acting cylinder. Now we will connect the B port with the retracting end of the double acting cylinder. So we required a longer one hose pipe for this connection. So the output from the retracting end will be connected like this. And the other end or the T fitting of this retracting end will be connected with the bleed off valve. So we required another hose pipe for this. So we'll connect it carefully to the, sometimes it is difficult to work with the hydraulic circuits here, and this will be connected with the T line of this. Do not make a sharp bend in the hydraulic lines. This will damage the hose pipe. Always use them with the easy bands and let them resembles in free condition. Now the tank port of the or T port of the 4x3 control way 4x3 way hand lever valve will be connected to the other end of this tank outlet for the bleeding off circuit. For this we'll use another hose pipe. So carefully connect this. Let me come on the other side for connecting it to the tank line. So this is the connection. Now output from this bleed off circuit will be connected to the tank port or tank manifold. So we'll connect it like this, and this will be connected to the tank manifold. So this is the complete hydraulic circuit of bleeding of circuit over here. You can do the connections as described in this video and perform your experiment using the 4x3 hand lever operated valve with the hydraulic system. Just need to control the direction of flow over here from the retracting end, and you can check the position of hydraulic cylinder in the movement. So now we move on to our next experiment. In this experiment, we will study the operation of double acting cylinder. List of equipments is described over here. The procedure is described in the user manual, and this is the connection diagram. So we'll do the connections and observe the study. For this, we just need to connect the P manifold or the pressure manifold to the P port of the 4x3 hand lever operated valve. For this, we use the hose pipe or P manifold like this. Connect it on the P manifold, then we connect it to the P port of the 4x3 hand lever operated valve. Then we will connect the A port, which is connected right now with the, when we operate this any of the direction, this will connect to the P port to A port, and we require a shorter length hose for this. So this will be connected with the A port of this double acting cylinder like this, and the return line of the double acting cylinder will be connected with the B port of the 4x3 hand lever operated valve. Properly connect the fittings. And now we will connect the tank line to the tank manifold. For this, again we use the hose pipe. For this, tank manifold will be connected to the tank NRV line, and the outlet will be connected on this. So this is how you do the connections, or properly do the connections, and after that we can observe some of the conclusion given in the user manual. Now what happens over here, as soon as we operate the valve lever, actuate it in the first position, which is the upper one, the pressure line will connect it to the A port over here. So A port will be provide flow to this line, and cylinder starts extracting towards upwards end. Then as the lever is released, at the next step, the spring in the valve resets to neutral position. In this position, the fluid from P port will be start flowing to T port and cause the steady state of the piston rod. That's at that position, the piston will be remains steady at the extracting position. Then when we operate this valve downwards, this will do the vice versa connection. In this case, P will be connected to the B port over here. So B will start, the oil flow will be starts in this direction over here, and the oil field inside the tank will start flowing outwards from this, and as the position downwards achieve, A will be connected to tank port, so that release oil will be go to the tank through the tank manifold, and the as the flow of the oil goes from the upper end, the cylinder starts retracting towards its original position. So this is how we can control the double acting cylinder using 4x3 hand lever operated valve. Now we'll do the connections for the next experiment. In this experiment we will be see the operation of single acting cylinder. The circuit diagram is given over here. List of equipments is also given, and the procedure is given in the user manual. You can follow the procedure, and also I will explain it into the video for doing the connections. For this you will need to connect the pressure reducing valve outlet is already connected to supply pressure line of P block, and T manifold is already connected to directly tank. Now for this connections we just connect the P manifold using quick release couplings. P will be connected with the P of 4x2 hand lever operated valve. So we required to use 4x2 hand lever operated valve for this experiment. Then the A port will be connected with the A port of the single acting cylinder. And this is the A port of the single acting cylinder. Here the return line and pressure line will work from the single side, so we just need to connect the tank line now to the tank manifold. You can use the B line, but you can use only one of the line while working with. So these are the connections for the experiment number 7. Just need to perform all the connections like this, and you can perform your experiment as described. Now what happens over here, as soon as this lever is actuated towards downward, the P port of this 4x2 way hand lever operated valve will connected with the A port, and supply pressure will start filling inside the tank or the cylinder. The cylinder starts extracting out towards upwards direction. Then as the lever is released, as its next step, the spring valve in the valve resets the first position, and fluid starts flow from P to T over here in this condition. So oil will start flow from P to T, and cylinder will start to the downwards position in the retracted position, which is the original position of this. So this is how single acting cylinder works with this 4x2 hand lever operated valve. So this is how you can do your connections. I have explained you how to do the connection with the complete trainer. Just you need to do connection and start your pump and get the experiment done, as you can do it in your own place. This is a demo piece. This cannot perform all the experiments right now, but as I explained this video, follow the instruction as I explained, as I suggest. Just do your experiments without any hesitation as explained. And if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. So these are some basic experiments that I have performed with the connections over here. Experiments cannot be performed over here, but you can do your experiments as I suggested and described in this video. And there are some experiments about the symbol learning, which you can do on your own while working and referring the user manual. And some experiments are for the safety precautions, what safeties and what the precautionary actions you need to take while working with the hydraulic components or hydraulic circuit trainers. So this is for today, and always carry the garbage clothes while working with the trainer. So if you are working with the trainer and there is oil flow, continuously oil leakage, start cleaning it, otherwise your components will get dirty, or that can be harmful for the oil components also. And if you use the user manual, study it properly, you can do your experiments without any hesitation as I explained in this video. Till then, if you like this video, please press like button on the YouTube, and you can share this video to your friends, colleagues and class fellows while to spreading the knowledge about this type of trainer kits and this type of components working in the industries. Also, you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. Also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you can get the notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.